Hey, hi there, you guys, Gemini. Welcome to your general forecast. Crosswatcher energies are interchangeable, but only take those portions that are resonating with you. And remember to check out your Moon and Rising and Venus sign videos for a more complete picture. My readings, they do meld together. And I really want to thank you guys, Gemini, for supporting my channel. The likes and the subscribes and the comments and those donations, they help me out a lot. Thank you so very much. Today you're going to get 5 cards from the Rider-Waite deck and 1 card from the Wisdom of the Oracle. And now here's your first card. It's the general atmosphere. It's the background and the basis of the matter. Gemini, you've got the King of Cups, water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. This could be a Scorpio. Doesn't have to be, though. This is someone that is caring and sensitive. They're composed. They're wise and calm, and they hold in complex emotions. They could be a healer or a counselor. They're relaxed and they're non-threatening, and they're reliable. They're a creative type. This is a situation that is favorable if it has to do with something you're creating. This is someone that, when they're in love, they worry things over and over like a terrier with a bone. This is a person that is a wonderful counselor and advisor. They're emotionally mature. They're careful and empathetic and a very understanding listener. They're very well liked. This is someone that keeps their cool. Now, they would rather get an emotional reaction out of you. This is someone that is controlling or concealing emotions. This is someone that can diffuse tense situations. They keep confidences. And they provide emotional support from a position of strength. Your second card, and this is the energy that's crossing over your path. These are your subconscious influences, Gemini. 7 of Pentacles, Earth energy. This is Saturn in Taurus. This is waiting and wondering if all those efforts you've been putting in is worth it. It's taking your time to consider all these options, and it's a pause during the development, a break, a reevaluation. It's stepping back and looking at what you've already accomplished, but that harvest is still yet to come. You've been working on something for a while now. And you're looking back and rethinking. It's also reaching a milestone, and it's taking stock and taking care of your possessions and your investments. Now, in this position, these energies are challenged, restricted. And this is also a Saturn card, which brings in blocks and restrictions. Now, this is someone that could be impatient. They have apprehension and suspicion. They desire something, or their efforts may be scattered. They may be spending time and money and that will not work out or pay off. They could also be not admitting defeat. And something really may be not worth your time, no matter how much you try. It could be a relationship. And there's been enough evaluating. This is someone that needs to act. Or in this position, this is someone that may need to plant seeds in more fertile fields. Pack it in. Try something new. Try something else. And you'll need to prioritize your activities carefully. This can be a fear of success or failure, and even self-sabotage from ego. The King of Cups with the 7 of Pentacles is tending to emotional fulfillment, and that takes time and consistent effort. Here's your third card. This is how it affects you. These are the external influences that you're consciously aware of, Gemini. Number 4 of the Major Arcana in the Rider-Waite deck, the Emperor. This could be an Aries or a Scorpio. This card is ruled by Mars. This has to do with control, authority, and leadership. This can represent a person. They could be rather proud and intimidating. They can be hard to please because they have the highest standards. They're very confident. You may have heard him say things like, been there, done that, and they command respect. This could be a father, could be a boss. This is someone very powerful, and they rule, and you might feel under their influence, which can become repressive. All this structure, control, authority, laws, and rules. This is a solid-born leader, and they have the right to rule. So look for issues related to authority. This is a protective male force, especially of the home and of domestic harmony. This is also realizing your goals or reaching out to begin, and you may be required to take charge. The King of Cups with the Emperor card is staying emotionally where you are. It's emotional stability. This can also represent a strong man who cannot connect with his emotions. Your fourth card, the card of the future, the outcome, the results, and the advice. Gemini, here's your prediction. Number 0 of the Major Arcana, the Fool. This can be an Aquarius or an Aries. This is the first of the Major Arcana of the 22 cards that show hidden meanings, karmic lessons, major life themes. This is a new path in seeking the truth. There's innocence and lightness and trust. This can be a choice offered. It could be travel. It's a beginning, an entrance, but not quite there yet. It's trusting life and taking that blind leap of faith. It's having absolute faith in the universe. It's taking steps, taking a risk, with no preconceived perceptions. This can be a new and unexpected opportunity, and it may appear out of nowhere. It's new and unknown and unfamiliar. It can be a surprise, and now anything is possible. And there is unlimited potential. This could be someone that may act on a whim. They take life as it comes, and they enjoy the moment. They may be simplifying. The Fool can be rather impetuous, and sometimes they act without thought or care. Maybe they're making it up as they go along. It's facing the world carefree, and it's time for a brand new adventure. So use an open mind and stay open to surprises. This is a very important new beginning, you guys, Gemini. The King of Cups with the Fool card is protecting deep emotions by displaying a carefree attitude. It's understanding that time is right for a new chapter. It's trying to understand a new situation or a choice. This may be impulsive. Someone may be emotionally distant and protecting deep emotions. Here's your fifth card. It's the bottom of the deck card. The underlying issue. This is what's unseen. It's unseen because it's something that you're not sharing with others, yet you are consciously aware of this, Gemini. Number 12 of the Major Arcana, the Hanged Man. This card is ruled by Neptune. This could be a Pisces. Pisces could be in your chart or someone else's that you're dealing with. Neptune always brings in a little bit of watery confusion. This is a suspension, a delay, reversal, a new perspective. It's an attachment. It can be a sacrifice for a sacred pursuit. And it's surrendering to what is. It's a self-surrender to a higher wisdom and seeing things differently than others. It's looking from all different angles, waiting and working on yourself before you can actually do it or make up your mind. And this does represent a person who will not be moved until they're good and ready. Yet they might be feeling like they're clinging to something unfulfilling. They'll need to let go and move on. This is a sacrifice for a greater good. It's a light bulb moment, and a voluntary giving up of something in order to get something of a greater value. You put yourself in this position. It's uncomfortable, but you know it's for your own good. And you're taking care of your problems first before you can actually move on. This is a pause in someone's life. Suspended decisions. King of Cups with the Hanged Man is reigning in and controlling an emotional, pivotal moment. It's a suspension of emotion. It's emotional control and restraint that's used. It's passively observing and gaining an intuitive understanding and seeing things differently. The Seven of Pentacles with the Emperor card. It's trying not to be overly concerned with disapproval or criticism from others, or your partner, or your boss, or loved ones. It's controlling impatience. The Seven of Pentacles with the Fool card is a new beginning that you have to be patient for, you've been waiting for. It could also be earning the good life, and also a fun work routine. Seven of Pentacles with the Hanged Man is waiting and contemplation with patience. It's reflecting on what has not been successful in the past. Could be some anxiety and confusion here. The Emperor with the Fool card. This could be an authority figure. They may reprimand someone for taking steps that carry a risk. This is a mentor, a start with someone who has a major role in your life. The Emperor with the Hanged Man is a feeling of failure or being played false. These are events beyond your control. This can represent a person who is independent and they try to impose order. They may be domineering and bossy. The Fool with the Hanged Man is strong advice to follow your own mind and not other people's advice. These can be plans delayed, and it's growing through having experiences. Here's your Wisdom of the Oracle card by Colette Baron Reed. Card number 42, Gemini, chop wood. Card number 42, chop wood. Being grounded in everyday experience, humility. There are times when the big dream is meant to lie dormant in your consciousness so that you can pay attention to the simple chores in your life. Consider why pruning a tree is the forerunner of delighting in the beautiful blooms when it's in full blossom. The mundane act of pulling off the dead leaves, watering the soil, and then leaving it to nature take its course is an important step in manifestation. Taking your attention away from your goal brings you into a state of receptivity. There is a deeper purpose for releasing attachment. When you engage in everyday tasks in a meditative, contemplative way, you clear your energy to receive your aha moments. Well, that's the Hanged Man, which brings you ever closer to what you seek. Thanks, you guys, Gemini. I hope you stay tuned in and leave me a comment or a thumbs up, and please subscribe. Now remember, what goes around comes around, so I'm sending you guys out love and light and blessings. Thanks for watching.